I was 11 to 12 years old in fifth grade when I first had an attack. According to my neurologist, the brain is split up into four lobes, the back lobe, the front lobe, and the two side lobes. My epilepsy affects my frontal lobe, and it's the second worst epilepsy that you can have. The first is the back lobe, and the two sides are only minor. When I have an attack, I'll have one once a month, but I'm on medication now that regulates my seizures, and they help me not have them. Some of the barriers that I face with having epilepsy is that I have to constantly regulate what I do and how I eat and the stresses I put on my body. My seizures are caused by stresses that I do in everyday life. I have to make sure that I'm not putting in extreme cold or extreme heat because it might cause my body to overheat or overexhaust itself. And I can't drive, so I don't have freedom or independence like other people, but I've learned to live with it. My family, my epilepsy has affected my family in multiple ways. They've learned how to protect me and help me when I have a seizure, and they've learned how to help me when I'm having one because I totally black out and I have no idea what has happened after I have one. And they are the ones that help me because I don't have the independence as a normal 20-year-old. And epilepsy does run in my family. It runs on my dad's side, my family, and that's according to my neurologist, that's majority of people who have epilepsy. It comes from the male side of the family.
My best friend Paul was diagnosed when he was about 7 or 8, but his mom noticed his first symptoms when he was about 3. He was walking on the beach, and his right footprint was like a drag mark instead of a footprint, and his doctor said it was just because he was flat-footed, and so he wasn't legally diagnosed until he was 7 years old after they got into a car accident, and it was his chiropractor that noticed it because his right side of his body was smaller than his left. All through elementary school and middle school, he had to go through different types of therapy, and it was like fine motor skills, speech, and physical therapy, because he would literally just like have like random muscle spasms. And we always had like an inside joke because he was like my little brother, and it was okay. But he would like literally, his arms would tense up and he'd feel like full T-Rex. Like his arms would literally just like go like this. But that's kind of like how I knew that something, you know, he was in pain or something like that, because I'd see his arms do that, or his leg would like jump really far. He also had like problems with sports, like he wasn't as athletic because he literally couldn't run for long periods of time. He couldn't jump because he would have like random muscle spasms. And then one of the other biggest problems he had was his speech. He had what was called a two-syllable stutter. It was like every two syllables he would stutter, so he almost literally could not get out a full word without a stutter. But he is a junior in high school now, and he is president of our high school's SGA and our chapters of FFA, and he gives speeches in front of 50,000 people now, so that's definitely something he's overcome. When he was about 14, he was also diagnosed with epilepsy, and it was really scary actually because I witnessed his first seizure. I was a TA for his English class that he was in. And he had been telling all day that he was really nervous about this speech that he had to give, that he was scared, he wasn't prepared for it. And he literally walked up to the front of the class, and I could tell he was nervous and he was like shaking. But then he literally looked at me, and like his eyes just like rolled back in his head, and he just completely seized. And that was the first seizure he had that he knew about, because apparently his doctor had said that he had many seizures and he never really realized since he was about 10. And his anxiety gets too bad, he literally can seize out. And it's really scary because you never know when it's gonna happen. Like, he'll say that he's completely calm, he's fine, but you can tell he's freaking out, and then he'll like have a seizure, and it's probably like one of the scariest things I've ever witnessed in my life.